Likely aware of the connection between the property and the missing girl, the tenant took the earring to the police. Frustratingly, however, the item would then be mysteriously mislaid. Listening to a description of the piece of jewelry, Denise was sure that it had belonged to her daughter. Yet no matter how much the family pressured law enforcement, the crucial piece of evidence was never found. Then, in November 1997, some 6 months after Kristen's disappearance, her family accused Flores of wrongful death in court. In his defense, the young man continued to deny playing any part in the strange case, and no charges were ever brought against him, either. So, as the years passed and Kristen failed to come home, Denise and Stan made a heartbreaking decision. In May 2002, the Smarts had their daughter legally declared dead. By then, a new law known as the Kristen Smart Campus Security Act had been passed that mandated better communication between college police and local law enforcement. Unfortunately, that policy came too late to save what many believed to have been a bungled investigation. And despite plenty of evidence and rumors, Kristen's disappearance remains unsolved. Then, 17 years after the introduction of this law, investigators finally announced a new lead. And with the help of cadaver dogs, officers subsequently conducted a search of an area close to Kristen's dorm. But even though several items of interest were reportedly found, the full details of the results of this operation have yet to be released. In September 2019, however, the case came into the spotlight once more thanks to Californian musician Chris Lambert and his podcast Your Own Backyard. During an episode of the show, Lambert discussed rumors that the missing woman was buried under concrete in one of the homes belonging to Flora's parents. Apparently, witnesses had even heard a beeping emanating from the yard of the Arroyo Grande property at around the same time that Kristen's alarm used to sound. Worryingly, Lambert also uncovered multiple reports from women claiming to have been assaulted and harassed by Flores. And with the case suddenly in the public eye once more, suspicion surrounding the potential suspect grew. Then, in January 2020, Kristen's family received some startling news. That month, Stockton, CA, newspaper The Record claimed that Denise had been contacted by the FBI, who had informed her that she might want to get away for a while. Apparently, a big break in Kristen's case was imminent, and the Smart family were understandably fraught with anticipation as they awaited the news. "I wish I knew when the break is going to come, because it's very anxiety-producing," Denise was quoted as saying in the article, which was published on January 18. "It's like, can you give me the flight plan? When is this happening?" Just days later, though, Kristen's family released a statement that seemed to contradict the previous claims. In the message, the Smarts clarified that it had been a retired FBI agent known to the family who had reached out rather than the Bureau itself. Furthermore, they claimed that no new announcement was expected in relation to Kristen's disappearance, an assertion that was backed up by the authorities. But only 7 days later, all that changed. On January 29, the San Luis Obispo County Sheriff's Office issued a press release confirming an apparent development in the case. Now, law enforcement were said to be in possession of two trucks that had belonged to Flores' family at the time of Kristen's disappearance. In the release, officials acknowledged that they were holding the trucks as evidence, although they did not say when they had taken the vehicles. Yet they did go on to give further insight into how the investigation had developed since a new sheriff had taken over in 2011. According to the sheriff's office, as many as 18 search warrants had been executed in relation to the case over the previous 9 years. The statement also confirmed that police had visited 9 different locations to search for physical evidence that may solve Kristen's disappearance. At the same time, they had conducted a thorough re-examination of everything currently held on record. Interestingly, this included submitting 37 items for DNA testing, technology that has improved vastly since the early days of the case. According to the release, this process has resulted in the acquisition of 140 additional pieces of evidence since 2011. On top of this, investigators have logged over 360 new reports and conducted more than 90 interviews. Altogether, then, officials estimate that some 7,500 hours, and around $62,000 have been spent on the case. So, although the official statement did not contain any dramatic revelations, many began to suspect that a big announcement was forthcoming. Then, on February 5, the San Luis Obispo County Sheriff's Office issued a second public message. This time, it confirmed that it had executed search warrants pertaining to 4 different areas in Washington State and California. On that occasion, the sheriff's office was unable to confirm the exact address of any of the locations being investigated. Nevertheless, local news station KKL-TV soon added another telling dimension to the story. Apparently, one of the locations was a home in San Pedro, CA, the current residence of the now 43-year-old Flores. And that wasn't all. The station reported that officers had also detained a man matching Flores' description outside the San Pedro property. Led to a vehicle in handcuffs, he was reportedly held in custody for 2 hours before eventually being released. Meanwhile, some 200 miles away in Arroyo Grande, the authorities had also descended on the home of Flores' mother, Susan. According to San Luis Obispo newspaper The Tribune, investigators sealed off the property with caution tape while a small crowd gathered to watch. Perhaps inspired by Lambert's podcast, some individuals even began heckling, allegedly yelling, "Dig her up," from the sidelines. And later that day, officers were spotted leaving the house with several pieces of potential evidence, including a computer and a storage container. Mere hours on, San Luis Obispo County Sheriff's Office spokesman Tony Cipolla confirmed that some items of interest had been recovered during the searches. In a February 2020 interview with the New York Times, he added, "We will now analyze those and see how they relate to the case. We would like nothing more than to bring closure to the Smart family in this case." To Kristen's parents, meanwhile, Lambert and his podcast have played a crucial role in these latest developments. In fact, even before the events of February 5, Stan and Denise released a statement thanking the musician for his input into the case. The pair said, "Your Own Backyard has been instrumental in renewing interest in Kristen's investigation and generating many new leads." Cipolla was quick to point out, though, that the sheriff's office has always remained dedicated to solving the mystery of Kristen's disappearance. In a statement issued on February 5, he explained, "This has always been an active investigation, it's never been a cold case." But were these recent searches just the latest in a long line of twists and turns? Or is a resolution finally on its way? For the grieving Smart family, they can only wait and hope.